Everybody doing today?
Good, how are you?
Fantastic. Happy New Year. Fire.
Go ahead.
The different characters, right? Like, how much is this exciting? Is it a challenge when you know you're going to have maybe some different guys out there getting reps?
Yeah, it is fun. You love to see guys who have worked hard, who have improved through the course of the year, who maybe haven't gotten as many snaps as they would like to get an opportunity. That's always fun to see him take advantage of that for sure. So we'll get some of that.
When you examine the whole year, just what has Drew meant to you from a versatile standpoint, playing a lot of different positions?
He has been fantastic. You know, from a versatility standpoint, as you mentioned, for sure, he can play multiple roles. He's been outstanding in terms of his ability to learn different roles. He works at it. He's, you know, we talked about something, you know, in terms of moving forward, a little bit of something different that, you know, he hasn't done, and he's already looking at it, you know, and he's already got good questions. So, you know, he's been a leader. He's got a professional attitude and mindset. He's been a lot of fun to have around.
How much of a hype man has Willie been on the sideline? You know, we see him getting engaged, getting energetic, especially that last game. How much of a hype man is he for the rest of the guys?
You know what? He brings great energy both on the sideline, in the game, and in the course of the everyday activities, whether it's meetings, whether it's walkthroughs. Like, he's an energy giver. There's energy vampires that are around. Willie is very much an energy giver.
Who's an energy vampire?
I'm not going to call out names. You've all been in a room or with someone you work with that's, you know, down all the time, doesn't have a whole lot of life to them. You know what I mean? Like, it's just not, it's not all that pleasant to be around them. Not that they're a bad person.
Hey, a big opportunity made for Nick Jones. What can we see with Jones?
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, well, it remains to be seen, but I think I'm excited. He's one of those guys, excited to see him play. You know, he's done a great job. He's learned things well. You know, he's been very diligent, comes in early in each morning to get kind of the preliminary game plan because he misses a little bit of a meeting to go to special teams and things of that nature. So I'm excited to see him get an opportunity.
Max was just in here saying basically he's told everybody to go about your business the way you normally would. There's a playoff game less than 2 weeks away. But from your standpoint, what are you going to be looking at? Are you really looking at more of the development? Are you looking at getting that 11th win? Are you looking at carrying on so that there is momentum in the playoffs? What do you focus on?
Well, I think there's an element of all of what you mentioned there. I would say my focus, though, is very singularly on this game. You know, you got guys that are playing different roles, that are playing different levels of snaps. It's total injustice, in my opinion, to not give those guys who are competing in this game every opportunity that you can give them to help them succeed. And so, to me, that's where the focus is. You know, I've gone about this week very structured and regimented, which we all are week to week, and tried to stay in that framework. You know, we'll get to next week. Next week, there's really not much we can do about that at this point. And to be honest, there's so many variables flying, still bouncing around in the air. Like, any work you do is probably going to be time misspent in some regard.
A couple more on the experimentation that you want to try and do this week, as far as maybe seeing guys in different positions.
I don't know how much of that we'll get into. Like, there's kind of some emergency type of situations that you got to be ready to deal with. That may create some of those situations, which, to be honest, that wouldn't be an awful thing in some ways. You know, with every negative comes a positive. One guy has an issue, somebody else gets an opportunity. So we're getting a little bit of that as we work through the week in terms of guys maybe preparing for maybe a second or third role that they haven't necessarily been ready to do in the past. So I do think there's some value in that in terms of guys growing, learning the overall system, understanding the big picture as opposed to just their specific role. There's certainly value to that.
Yeah. Do you feel like you guys are finding a happy medium for getting Drew and Nick both on the field and getting them enough snaps to take advantage of what they both have?
Yeah, I would say, you know, we feel good about where that's at least I do personally. I mean, honestly, you'd like to get them all more. You'd also prefer not to play 70, 100 snaps of defense in a game, too. So there's a, you know, there's a flip side to that. But it's worked out pretty well. I thought Nick got in a pretty good rhythm in this past game, you know, after all that he's battled through from an injury standpoint, from a conditioning and all those type of things. And Drew continues to make plays when he's out there, regardless of what role we put him in.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Yep. Thanks, thank you. Have a great day, guys.
You too.